number system, that is the octal number system. It has a base radix of 8. It uses 8 digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The position weight are power of 8. Now this table shows the octal equivalent of a decimal number system. In the decimal number system, the power weight, that is the position weight, is power of 10, and octal number system, the position weight is power of 8. We have the place value is 1, 10, 100. Here the place value is 1, 8, 64, 512, and so on. Here the decimal numbers are written and its equivalent octal numbers. That is, it comes from 0 to 7. 8, decimal 8 is written as 10. That is, 1 is written in the place value 8. For example, 13, 1 is written at the place value 8, and 5 is written at the place value 1. That is, 8 plus 5 is 13. Similarly, 27, 2, that the for 23, decimal number 23, we have the equivalent octal equivalent as 27. That is, 2 is written at a place value of 8. That is, 2 into 8 is 16 plus 7, which is equal to 23. And when we write 30, the 3 at the place value 8, which means 8 into 3, that is 24, and this is 0. The 24 plus 0 is 24. That is, decimal 24 is written as 30. The number increases, it comes to 77, and after that 100 means we have written 1 at the place value 64, which means that its decimal number is 64. Now let's convert a decimal number to octal number. We have taken the same number 86.625. okay, the integer part here, while converting into octal, decimal to octal, we have to divide it by 8. In binary, while converting decimal to binary, we had divided it by 2. Now we have to divide it by 8. That 86 divided by 8, 8 tens are 80, remainder 6. Then 8 ones are 8, remainder 2. 8 cannot be divided to 1, so this is 1 is carry forward. We write in a reverse order from MSB to LSB, and we get a number 126 in octal. Here the fraction part, which is multiplied by 8, we get 5. That is, 5 is an integer which is taken as remainder, and 0, that is a float, is carry forwarded. We get the number which is written from top to bottom, from MSB to LSB, the 0.625, its equivalent is 0.5 octal number. Therefore, the total 86.625 decimal number is equal to 126.5 of octal number. The next example is to convert 126.5, an octal number, to decimal. We have taken the same number to verify whether the result which we have got is right to decimal. The converting this to decimal, so what we have to do is we have to write this number, we have to write the position weightage or its place value. That is, the place value of this is 1, the place value of 8 is 2, 1 is it, and this is 64. Okay, now we have to sum the products of the place values. That is, we have 1 into 8 raised to 2, that is 64. Then 2 into 2, 8 raised to 1, that is 2 into 8, that is 16. And 6 into 8 raised to 0, that is 6 into 1 is 6. And plus 5 into 8 raised to minus 1, that is 1 divided by 8, that is 5 divided by 8, we get 86.625. therefore, the 126.5 octal number is equivalent to 86.625 of a decimal number. So this, which we had converted a decimal number to octal, we have reconverted in the reverse order from octal to decimal, the answers are the same. That is, they are right. We go to the next conversion, that is octal to binary conversion. This table shows the binary equivalent of the octal number. Octal number, it has a base of 8. It has number from 0 to 7. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Its binary equivalent, that is the highest number is 7, which is represented as 1, 1, 1. That is place value 4, we write 1. Place value 2, we write 1. And place value 1, we write 1. Okay, therefore 3 digits, that is 3 bits, are enough to represent an octal digit, that is the highest digit. Therefore, while converting an octal into binary, we write its binary equivalent in 3 bits. Now, we'll take an example, convert octal number 473.6501 octal number to binary number. Write this octal number as it is and writes its binary equivalent, that is 4's equivalent is 100. See, 4 equivalent is 100. We write 1 in the place value 4 and 00. That is 100 is the equivalent of 4. Then we have for 7 is 111, 3011. And after point, we have 6, which is represented as 110, 5101, 0 is 000, and 1 is 001. Okay, that is 473.6501 octal is represented by this number. Now we convert a binary number 1110.01 to octal. Now we write the binary number as it is. Now from the decimal point on the left hand side, we group it in 3 bits. Now we have grouped this in 3 bit. Now there is only one number. Now we add 2 more zeros. So 001 is equal to 1. 110 is 6.01. We add a 0. That is, we have to make a group of 3 bits. That we add a 0. That is 010, which is equal to 2. That is, the binary equivalent of this number is equal to 16.2.